神河
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 神河神河
神河
神
河
河
河
河神河
神河
神河神河。I keep saying 神河 It's 神河 Okay. Okay. I think I got this now. 神河。What's going on, guys? It's your boy Leaving Sunset, aka Michael here. Genshin Impact literally just dropped a new video a couple hours back. Kind of late on hopping onto it, but I thought it's better just to make a video than never. So we're gonna be getting right into things. Right now, we're gonna be watching the character teaser of 神河 or 神河 Lonesome Dream by Genshin Impact. It is currently top 15 on of trending for gaming, so that's pretty big. Yeah, let's just get right into it. Let's analyze the entire video and see what the fuck is up. I'm actually really excited for this, because I'm rolling for her. Okay, who's the girl? I'm guessing it's her, because we literally just wake up, we transition from this child to her. So.
Other nightmare.
Yeah, it's a
one
nightmare,
has
yeah.
told you before. Be not complacent. The ropes are to be worn even while you sleep.
Yes, master.
I think the dialogue right there is a little too fast. I wish they extended this video out to 2 minutes so we could kind of take in and absorb the dialogue. Like, when you listen to some of the edits and the cuts right here, it sounds a little too... It doesn't sound like we're hitting any beats, so I'll replay it.
Another nightmare. Huh? One has told you before. Be not complacent. The ropes are to be worn even while you sleep.
Yes, master.
Like, it sounds very rough right there, you know what I mean? And it isn't, as an audience or someone who's viewing this video for the first time, I don't feel like I'm absorbing the meaning behind this nightmare that 神河is having.
Complacent. The ropes are to be worn
those
even
those cuts
while you
are rough.
Sleep.
Yes, master.
That's just me nitpicking, though.
Rest, child. No need to train today.
Okay, she's looking at her reflection. And can we admire the scene? Like, aside from me nitpicking the video on the editing and the cuts and the dialogue and stuff, can we admire how fucking beautiful this scene is with the butterfly and 神河and her looking at her reflection? It's beautiful to me. And honestly, we could also see her image in clear and in full view without, you know, leaks and stuff like that, without just the battle animation and stuff like that. Like, this is actually one of the pure animated still images I could see of 神河. I think I saw a flower there. Yeah. So there's a flower right here, and there's a lot of floral accents that we could see from her costume design. And we could see the kind of the floral design patterns that we see all over her costume design, including the headpiece that she wears. Also, I really like the contrast of her colors. I mean, it really fits Liyue, and it fits the entire kind of gold scheme that we see here. And it looks really divine to me. Okay, this isn't a palace for Liyue.
You are a cursed child and shall never have contact with anyone else.
I wonder who says that dialogue. Is that her past family? Or is it somebody connected to the Adepti and the Cloud Retainer and stuff like that? I'm gonna go off the limb and say it's her past family. And I don't think I don't think they're alive anymore, or something happened or whatever, and she ran away, and she is now the disciple of the Cloud Retainer, and she took her under her wing, like literally under her wing, and started training her. I do believe that whoever that was, maybe was the father figure of 神河or something like that. Or maybe even like a village chief, and she got banished for being a cursed child. Oh shit, it's the boy Aether!
Traveler, we offered so many tasty dishes.
Damn, already making the fucking heads turn. And could we actually, could we admire how their hair designs are actually so fucking similar, and the braids and stuff like that, and how, like, you see this parallel between her and the traveler going opposite directions. So literally their paths have intertwined, and I'm wondering how they're gonna intertwine right here, because this character trailer, not only are we gonna get her character story or her own side story quest that we could unlock via daily keys that we get, but we're also gonna get a new Archon quest when it comes to the version 2.4 update. So we're also gonna get probably some sort of intertwinement of Shenhe's character into the Archon quest, which is gonna be pretty awesome if my prediction's right.
We're sure to get Cloud Retainer's attention, right? If she still doesn't want to meet us, then maybe we can take all the food back.
Wait, hold up.
If she still doesn't want to meet, we offered so many tasty dishes. We're sure to get Cloud Retainer's attention, right? If she still doesn't want to meet us, then maybe we can take all the food back.
Okay, so that's interesting. What Paimon's dialogue is implying that because Cloud Retainer doesn't want to meet us, even though we're giving her tasty dishes. See how the paths intertwine here? Meaning that Shenhe is going to be our connection to meeting the Cloud Retainer later on in the storyline. I think that is going to be our key to meeting the Cloud Retainer once again. It's through Shenhe or Shenhe. I think that's beautifully well done with this with the cinematics and the animation and just the cinematography in general, and how everything means something in the grand scheme of things, especially in this image right here. I think this is a really good image, by the way. I'm wondering what the whole entire connection is with this whole cursed child thing that she gets from this nightmare Shenhe, and how we see her here as a young girl transition into this beautiful woman who is now kind of on this path to find herself, basically. I'm also wondering how her hair changed color, where it changed from kind of like this bluish, blackish hue, whatnot, to this kind of silver, platinum, whitish, kind of like a moonlight hair color. I'm wondering if it has to do with A, her curse, her being a cursed child, and it her like affecting her physical well-being, if she's like sick or something like that and the Cloud Retainer is like helping heal her. B, if she is part of this like dynasty, or like, I don't know, maybe this like special bloodline of being a cursed child, but she's not actually a cursed child, she just has like some sort of crazy power, something maybe connected to Adepti, but she's not technically an Adepti, something in her blood, something kinda we don't know much about, we're gonna explore it later on in the story. Or third, most importantly, she's somehow related to the Cloud Retainer, maybe she's like the daughter or something. I've heard theories of that on Reddit, but I'm not too sure. I would kind of guess that this maybe has something connected to her her vision in general, and you know how visions kind of change people. You know how, like, for example, the Archon quest, when you take away a vision, you take away a part of somebody. I'm wondering if that vision has something to do with her, you know, kind of changing her physical well-being and her developing this kind of, like, platinum snow-like hair because of the cryo vision. I'm wondering if that's sort of a thing as well. This is the title of the trailer, and it says, an Adepti disciple with a most unusual air about her. Having spent much time cultivating in isolation in Li Wei's mountains, she has become every bit as cool and distant as the Adepti themselves. She kind of reminds me of Ganyu in retrospect. She seems very quiet and shy. Vision, Cryo, Constellatius, Crista Dolores, Weapon, Polearm, Affiliation Li Wei, Birthday March 10. Shenhe is a support character who can increase the cryo damage dealt by all nearby party members. This was also This was also leaked or just teased a bit in the trailer. They announced that she's going to be a support character. Shenhe can summon a talisman spirit to help her in combat, and her elemental skill grants all nearby party members the icy quill effect that will increase her cryo damage. Kind of like Kujosara's ability to increase electro damage for Electro party members. Story: Shenhe was originally from a branch family of exorcists, but due to a series of coincidences, she became the disciple of an adepti, or an adeptus. I'm guessing, yeah, she was abandoned by her family, being a part of a family of exorcists, kind of like Chongyun. Seeing how they how they are together, I kind of want to see how Chongyun and Shenhe relate via storyline and how they relate because of the whole family of exorcist thing. She is student solely of Cloud Retainer in name, but her impressive constitution and intelligence quickly won several other adepti over. She would go on to learn from them all, eventually becoming a master of adeptal arts in her own right as a mortal. So she has learned combat and whatever, any type of knowledge, abilities, things like that from other adepti. However, it is precisely due to the long years of tutelage that she has lacked company save for the adepti and odd passing illuminated beasts. So she is kind of lonely. She feels very isolated. She feels as if kind of back to her childhood days. That's why she has those nightmares. I'm guessing the Traveler is going to have some sort of impact or leave an impression on her. This isolation has caused her to grow distant and indifferent. The assumption that every person has somewhere to call home is naive. I got used to living in the mountains alongside the birds and beasts a long time ago. Yeah, so she does seem very cold. Kind of why she got the cryo vision. I'm just kidding. It's pretty fucked. Yeah, I knew originally her hair was fully black, but possibly from the adepti binding her soul, who brings misfortune and harms people around her, coupled with the years of cultivation, it has most likely turned white. Yeah, see, that's a nice theory. I like that. Y'all removed her belly button. Do you see the shit? Bursibatos. Oh, that's funny that they have the Rosaria thing here, too, because, you know, Rosaria, she got nerfed. She got nerfed. But yeah, that's about it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Subscribe button's down below. It's free. Check it out. Check out my other videos. I just posted a couple other recent new videos on my channel. Tell me what you guys like about her character or the character trailer in the comment section down below. Give this video a like and subscribe. We're going to be creating more content in general, not just Genshin content, but also more content spanning variety. But we will be seeing more Genshin content in the future. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. The sun has set. I will see you guys next time.